Hey y'all, welcome to my channel. If you guys are new, my name is Cass. I talk all about DIY content creation, you guys. And today we are creating some photo collage edits in Photoshop. Let's get it. Side note, I am launching a Patreon. It's $5 a month if you guys want to just help support my channel. I'm going to be posting exclusive content on there, ad-free content, some live streams, all kinds of stuff, some video tutorials, things that will not be here on YouTube. The first post will be coming this weekend. I'll link the information for that below. Definitely subscribe if you are interested. I have so much stuff planned for that, so I'm super, super excited. Of course, you guys, I started with a DIY at-home photo shoot. I have tons of videos on how to do that, as well as how to build your own home studio. If you guys are interested in that, but today I want to get more into the editing for the photo shoot itself. I just use a blue seamless paper backdrop from Savage. I'll link that below. I use my two studio softbox lights, and then I just use some props like a fan, a cooler. The theme was icy. After I did the shoot, it was time to edit. So I opened up Photoshop and I selected open to select the photo that I wanted to get started with. So you want to choose the photo that's going to be the main photo in the background to be your start photo. So I decided to go with the photo with the open cooler so I can make some things kind of stick out the cooler. But first I needed to extend my backdrop. In order to extend my backdrop, I use the selection tool and I just select a portion of the backdrop that is clean and has nothing on it. Then I go to edit, free transform, and then I'm going to hold down shift and drag down where I want the background to extend. So just make sure you're holding shift when you drag it, and then it should extend your background. So now I'm going to kind of do that once again just to kind of expand the background as much as possible. And so this is a really good technique if you actually bought studio backdrops that are a little too thin like mine, or you just need to clean up something. So now I'm just cleaning up the rest, doing the same technique, just finding clean spots where the backdrop is clean so I can drag it and expand it. So I do have this little part here where it's not clean, so I'm just going to duplicate my background layer. And then you guys will just see me go to edit, transform, and then I'm going to flip it because I'm going to actually cut out the layer that's flipped. So I'm putting the original layer on top so we can see that. And then I'm just going to go into the lasso tool with my top layer selected in Photoshop, and I'm going to cut out that little piece there, and I'm going to try to finesse it with the layer that is now underneath. So I'm just using my magnetic lasso tool to cut that portion out, ending where I started. And then I'm going into layer mask, and then I want to hide what I just selected. So now that photo underneath is showing through, so that's why I flipped it horizontally. So now I'm just going to clean it up a little bit using my eraser tool. Make sure you guys have the mask of that layer selected, and then it should let you erase any kind of messy spots. We're going to kind of fix that coloring here a bit later, but at least we kind of have the backdrop look. So I'm adding another layer, and I'm going to actually use my brush tool to kind of clean this up a bit. So I'm expanding my brush size, and then I'm going to click the color and use my eyedropper tool to select the nearest color to what the actual backdrop color is. So now I'm just kind of painting that in. You guys can modify your brush size as needed. I suggest having very little low hardness so it's not too harsh. And then I'm just kind of coloring in so that the backdrop blends a lot better. So I'm gonna select my color again, use my eyedropper tool since this color area is a little bit different. And then same thing, just painting in that area. I know it doesn't have to be perfect for this because I know I'm gonna bring in another thing, but if you guys mess up a little bit, just switch back to your eraser tool and just kind of erase that. And I'm just using like the touchpad on my laptop. So I'm going back into Finder, and now I'm gonna add my next photo. So for the next photo, I just wanted to kind of have me sitting off to the side there. So I'm going to use my magnetic lasso tool to cut myself out with collages. You guys, it's a lot of cutting yourself out and then pasting yourself where you want to be placed. I like using the magnetic lasso tool, especially if I'm very contrasted from the background, because then it's a lot easier to cut myself out. And I just kind of click on different areas where it may be a little bit tougher for it to cut me out. Or if there's like a color change, I just do a click just so it's a bit more accurate. So once you're in where you started, you can click the little mask icon but under layers. I'm just going to feather it a little bit in the properties window. If you guys are missing any of these windows, just go to window at the top of Photoshop and either select properties or layers or tools. Those are the three windows that I'm using if they're not open already. From there, you guys, I'm using my transform tool just to kind of move myself around and place myself where I want to be placed. Now I'm clicking on the mask of the image that I just added. And I'm using my eraser tool to kind of clean that up a bit. Again, you can go up and modify the brush again. So I use a very low hardness on my brush, you guys, so it's not too harsh when I clean myself up. So now we're bringing in the next photo. For the next photo, I wanted my legs to kind of come out the cooler. So I chose one of the photos with my legs up. And then once again, I'm going to my magnetic lasso and I'm just going to chop myself out. And then this time I know my head's not going to be in it, so I'm just cutting out the leg portion. Again, with the magnetic lasso, I'm just clicking every once in a while. You guys can kind of see when my mouse clicks, just to make sure it gets it pretty accurately. Whenever I just hover, it's kind of magnetically guessing the area. If you click, it actually puts it in that area, so that kind of helps a little bit. So once again, I'm adding some feather, switching to my transform tool, and then just dragging that where I want it to be placed. I do want it to look like I'm in the cooler, so I'm actually going to swap to my eraser tool. Again, make sure you have the mask layer selected in your layer window, and then I'm just going to erase the part of me that is supposed to be in the cooler and behind homegirl sitting down. So I'm just using my eraser tool and cleaning that baby up. And then you can switch back to your brush tool and make sure the colors are white and black. And then that way you can bring anything back. So anything you need to erase, brush tool. Anything you need to clean up, anything you need to bring back, brush tool. Anything you need to erase, eraser tool. When I'm doing precision cleanups, I play around with the brushes a lot with the hardness and the size just to get it where I really want it. Of course, you guys can zoom in and get very, very specific with this. So now I'm just going to go ahead and add a few more pictures, you guys. I'm going to use the same process. Click, drag, and drop the picture into Photoshop. Use my magnetic lasso tool to cut the photo out. Select my mask icon at the bottom of layers so that it cuts out. And then just kind of use the transform tool to move it, place it wherever I want it to be placed. And lastly, just clean it up with my eraser tool and my brush tool. With the mask layer selected, that's crucial. If you see it's not erasing or it's not brushing back, go to your layers and make sure the actual mask, that black and white icon in the layers panel, is selected. Alright, so now my photos are cut out, so I'm just going to export them and bring them into Lightroom so I can edit the coloring and everything, make it blend a little better. We are in Lightroom, so I'm going to switch over to develop mode. I just dragged my photo into the library, and I'm going to use the SP5 Nate filter. I'm just going to bump up the exposure a little bit on that filter, turn down my shadows, down my blacks a little bit, and then I'll bring the exposure back up a little bit more. From there, I'm going to take away texture and clarity. Y'all know that's my thing. And then I'm going to turn up saturation so we have a little bit more color in there. I'm going to change the hue of the blue a little bit for the cooler. And then from there, the only other things I did, I added a little bit of a black vignette into these photos, just a tiny bit, and then I added some grain, and that was the edit that I ended up with. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope y'all go out, create some fun collages. You guys can do a lot with this technique. I hope it inspires you to go out and create, and I'll see you guys in the next video.